this opportunity, Morelia Media and I are going to present a performance about the book Black Transition. Yes.
Chapter 2. Black Pearl Fisher. The sun was shining brightly on the blue water of the Atlantic Ocean. A beautiful big ship with flags, white sails, and the English flag was sailing towards the Bermuda Triangle. The ship's name was the Puna, and it was going to the Bermuda Triangle to trade gold. The captain of the ship was in his cabin, writing in his logbook.
Sunday 10 of December 1712 is the 70th day of our voyage, and still no island sight. The men are beginning to complain. I am afraid they are going to create problems.
A knock at the door stops the captain from arriving.
Enter,
captain. A starship is sailing towards us. It has no flag, so we don't know where it comes from. They need to on the bridge.
I'll be at him in a moment.
The crewman closed the door in the captain wrote one more sentence in the lookbook.
Allah, we have just changed.
The strange ship was cut a mile from the Puna. It looked all abandoned. The captain brought his telescope up to his eye.
Say, close to it, and we'll see anyone.
Is on board. One of the crewmen flies away this time quickly, waiting 1 second, then flies into more lines. There was no answer.
Open the cannon and see next week.
The strange ship moved slowly through the water. There seemed to be no one on board. The sail had forced in there, and there was perfect water all over its deck. The captain called over to it.
I'm Captain Scott, Sir Herring, Majesty the Queen. If anyone is on board, state your name and who you serve.
There was no answer.
Lower the boat. Lower the boat and we're going aboard.
Captain Scott and 12 of his men rowed to a small foot from the pew and to the empty ship. A row ladder was hanging down from the ship's side. The captain and his men used it to climb aboard. There was no one on board. The captain and his men looked around the ship, but they found nothing. There was no one at the wheel, but the ship somehow continued silent.
I've never seen anything like it, Captain.
They don't have eyes, and I don't like it. Let's follow it and see where it goes.
They were ready to leave when one of the men saw a ship at the side of the ship, under some orphan's necks. They took off the necks and brought the world, black block, inside the soul. Beautiful shining diamonds, pearls, and gold. The men were stunned into sight. The captain looked at one of the world coins. He had a picture of King Edward the Sixth of it.
This coin is over 100 years old. It's not even in use anymore.
What should we do, Captain?
I don't see. Why we should keep it here when there is no one on board? Close it. We'll take it with us.
When all the men were looking at the treasure, something like a glass shell held to the top of the stair going down to the path below. It stepped back in the darkness of the street until the men moved the chest to their foot. No one could see it, but the shadow was really a ghost that looked like a fire. It wore a long blue coat and had a shadow. sword at his side. He carried a red scarf around his head and a long, deep black beard. He followed the man to the wood and sat on top of the chest. No one could see him, but he was the black beard.